The Qantas chairman has announced his departure date, saying he'll step down by next November as the airline seeks to repair its reputation. Richard Goyder is among four board members set to retire, the company conceding that it does need a renewal to restore the trust of its customers.
The turbulence has proven too much. The Qantas chairman vacating his seat, Richard Goyder, only weeks ago, telling a Senate inquiry,
"I'll continue to serve because I think we've got some very significant challenges in front of us and issues to deal with."
Those issues including reputational repair after the High Court ruled the airline acted illegally when it sacked 1,700 ground crew during the pandemic. Also being sued by the competition regulator for allegedly selling seats on already cancelled flights, and the board's approval of a $10 million bonus for former chief executive Alan Joyce.
A smooth and timely transition of the Qantas board and management is needed to regain the trust of the Australian travelling public.
Chairman Richard Goyder will step down ahead of the annual general meeting in late 2024. Michael L'Estrange will retire next month, and Jacqueline Hay and Maxine Brenner will follow suit early next year. Five directors will offer themselves up for election to the board. CEO and Managing Director Vanessa Hudson, Doug Parker, Dr. Heather Smith, Todd Sampson and Belinda Hutchinson.
But critics are calling for Goyder's departure date to be expedited. They're also labelling today's announcement as a reshuffle rather than a renewal to address the airline's reputational issues.
There should be a worker representative on the board so that we can avoid the type of situation we've just seen, a corporate dictatorship illegally sack 1,700 workers.
One of many hurdles ahead for the Flying Kangaroo. Paris Martin for 10 News First.